off to a big flex meeting today. Big flex meeting. I'm just on my way to pick up Pete. Pete and I, we always carpool into the office because he lost his license in a DUI. So, and there was like a, lady of the night in the car too. So, it was a little weird, but, so I have to pick him up every morning, no big deal, but we're going to the office. We're going to, meet with a customer on a big flex deal. So, should be an exciting day. So come on aboard. Welcome aboard. Good morning. All right. Which one is his house? Oh yeah, here we go. Come on. There he comes. Look at that. I'm going to have to fix that tie and that button that suit a little bit, but should be good. Hey, buddy. Ryan. Morning, buddy. You ready to go?
Let's do it.
All right, hop in. Let's go.
All right.
Big day. Pretty exciting. We're going on a big flex meeting. Come on. Yeah,
yep.
Big flex meeting.
Yep.
Excited about this because Pete's here along with me. He's coming into the meeting. He's, he's like my little protege. I'm his mentor, so that's cool. So we really need to sell this deal. I mean, this is a big deal.
Company needs... Do you have? Is that eyeliner?
What?
Are you wearing eyeliner?
No, I'm not bloody wearing bloody eyeliner.
Oh, come on! It's a little early for the fake British accent, Lynn.
Ooh, fake British.
You're not gonna do this in the meeting, are you?
No, I'm not gonna do it in the meeting.
Like the last meeting, you said you weren't.
I'm not gonna do it. I promise. I'm not gonna do it. Why? What do you think? I am an idiot? Oh, hello. What about some bloody flex? Hello, let's get some
of
bloody flex.
Of course, I don't think
I'm on a big flex meeting.
Of course, I don't think you're an idiot. I just think sometimes you forget where you're at, Lynn.
Hello, you want to buy some flex? I'm a British robot.
And the accents, it's not even that. It's not really any good.
It's kind of part Scottish, isn't it? Hello, it's Scottish.
You sound like a leprechaun a little bit.
Hey, I'm a leprechaun. You want to buy some bloody flax from me?
Don't.
Hello!
Don't go Irish. Mm. We really need to have this deal. Company needs this deal. No fake accents. No British robots. Right? We're good? We're cool on this?
We're cool. So Pete's always worried that I'm going to do something stupid in the meeting, like to a British accent or something, but he doesn't understand sales, you know? They expect you to go the extra mile. Like, what are you going to do for us today? You want to make a sale? You put on a little British accent. You do a little British thing and say, hey, you want to buy some flex? I'm British. I know you won't go buy some flex if I use this accent. It works every time. They just go, oh, he's so funny, there's a British accent. He does a little flexing, you know? So, and throw in a little robot, and now you're really going... But he doesn't understand that. That's why I'm the mentor and he's the Mentos.
I've learned a lot from Lynn over the years. Not really any of it related to sales per se. He's a good manager, I guess. But, you know, he just, when he does that British accent in the meeting and that weird robot thing, I don't think customers really like it, and I don't think it's very professional.
Q.
Good try, buddy. Good try.
Z.
Z. No. No Z. Come on, Jer. Come on. P. P.
How about an F, Lynn?
You're not playing, Pete.
F.
F. Pete already said F. You have to guess another one.
L.
That's not fair.
E.
It's not fair.
X.
Pete, you're not playing. You're ruining the whole game.
Flex. That spells flex, Jerry.
You ruined the whole game. You ruined the whole game. I start every meeting out this way. Keep things fresh. Keep things fresh and happy. So, Jerry, good to see you. How are you?
I'm good.
Thanks for sitting down with us, Jerry. Appreciate it.
So we're going to talk about a little flex today. Pete, it's all yours.
All right. So our flex product, what it allows you to do is have one central server in your data center, and you can have all your users, 500 of them, 1,000 of them, with their laptops and their desktops, and they can all be booting that, off of that.
That's not really. Here, let me explain it to you. You like sports?
Yeah, I love sports.
All right, you like basketball?
Basketball's great.
All right, did you play basketball in high school?
Yes.
Okay, it's like this. So you go into the gym for PE, for basketball, and there's like having, the coach has one basketball in his office that is his prized basketball, and he never lets it go. But out in the gym, could be 1,000 basketballs, but the coach has one basketball over here in the gym, and there's a whole bunch of basketball just bouncing around out here in the gym. It's like that. It's a lot like that. Basketball.
Is that making sense to you, Jerry?
I'm not catching exactly what you're...
Basketball.
Okay, let me try again, Lynn.
All right.
So, you have the central server, and you have your Windows image loaded on it, and you're in your desktop, your laptop, you're in your office, right? You turn on your machine.
Okay.
It boots up off of that one image in the data center.
It's like cake.
And so everyone else
like
also...
It's more like cake. Do you like cake?
Yeah, I love
it. All right, so you ever go to a restaurant and they've got this great cake and it's like 7 layers and it's chocolate and it's mint and it's pudding and it's meat and it's like a bunch of like a spice layer with peppers?
I think I understand.
Let me finish this. So you have this cake and you take one piece and there's a whole cake for everybody else still, but you have your one piece.
So you have the server, you were...
Yeah, so you have the central server, right? And, you turn on your machine, it's set up to Pixie Boot, it goes to that central server, bam, loads up your Windows image, and you're live. And you can have all your different users booting up off of that one image.
Okay, I think I understand that.
Not really like cake at all, but...
But I understand. I think I got it. Does this support Windows 7?
Yes, absolutely. It'll support full support from Windows 7, Vista, XP, any version of Windows out there, full support.
All right. How about, how's this assigned? Is it by device, by user?
Actually, that's a good differentiator for us. It's actually assigned by user, so you put in your credentials and you get your image.
Okay.
Now, if you go to a different machine, you put in your credentials, you will get that same exact image that you were using in your office, and now maybe you're in your lab, or maybe you're in a completely different office. So it's actually all assigned.
All right.
You have the decision of user or device, but most customers choose user. They want it to follow them around.
You bet. Okay, that sounds good.
Great,
all right,
great.
Let's talk about the next level here. How about, do you offer fire suppression with this?
Fire suppression?
Yeah, fire suppression. You have a server.
The server.
Yes.
If the server catches on fire, it'll put itself.
Yes, we do.
You have that.
Yes, we do.
We've never seen any product with fire suppression.
Yes,
that's
we do. Yes.
That's what we need. Okay.
Absolutely.
So this sounds really interesting. So let's go where we need to. The economy, it's a little bad for us. So we need a little bit of a deal here. So we're talking fire suppression, the whole system.
Yes.
And we can pay nothing. We'll need it for free, just for now.
Like, just for you'll pay zero?
Yeah, just no cost.
For how long would you?
A period of time.
Like a period of time free.
We can work out the details with time. Just a little, free.
Free? Yeah. Bloody free?
Yeah.
Please. You want it for bloody free?
Yeah, you bet.
You know you're going to have to pay for it, don't you?
Yeah.
You can't play bloody free. Bloody free. I want my software for free.
Okay,
you can't have it for free.
We can pay.
You got to pay for it, right?
That is good. Yeah, we'll pay.
You got to pay for
it.
Hold on.
Yeah, no problem for free.
No, not free. You're going to have to
pay for it. We'll pay for it.
You can pay for it, right?
We'll totally pay for it.
Pay for it.
Can we
we'll pay for it.
Can we do one little
wait,
thing?
Wait.
We'll pay for it.
You just did a
Yeah, but it was
British
great.
Robot?
That was awesome.
You like the British robot.
That's awesome. That's
it's
worth
life.
That is worth
I'm
paying for.
For life free.
You
can't camp for free.
You like the British leprechaun robot.
Yeah, I love that.
It's awesome.
We need one little thing. We can close the deal. I need a cat with a laser beam.
A cat
on
with
its
a
head.
Like a laser cat.
A laser cat.
If our software came with a laser cat, you would buy our
fire
software.
Fire suppression and the laser cat. We
would
good.
Just buy it.
We got it.
Done! We gotta give him a
okay,
bloody laser
okay.
cat.
Okay, Jerry. It's coming out in the next version, which will be out in the next 30 days. It'll have laser cats with it in our next version. It's in beta right now. We can get you that beta copy if you want.
You got a deal.
Try it out right now. Great.
It's a bloody deal.
A pleasure.
Thank you.
You like the British robot?
Keep that. You know, if it wasn't for the British accent, the British accent was great. And the robot, that sealed it. That just sealed it.
This is Christian Tate.
Christian, hey. Lynn, Shourds, and Pete here.
Hey, guys. How are you?
We're good. Calling from the SoCal Flex office.
I know where you guys are from. What's up?
Well, we just closed the largest deal in Flex history.
Congrats, guys. It's great. This is huge.
That's what she said.
I'm sorry, Lynn. Did you say something?
Christian, there, however, might be a slight problem.
What kind of problem?
Well, to get the deal closed, we had to give the customer the new beta version of Flex.
And the problem is?
You know, the laser cat version of Flex?
Right. Didn't work?
Not at all. It worked great!
It did. Even the laser worked.
Absolutely.
So the customer's completely happy.
I would say the customer's a little more dead than happy.
More or less, mostly dead.
Completely dead, Christian.
Yeah.
Are they going to return the software?
No. No one liked the IT director there anyway.
So, what should we do about this in the next version of Flex?
Well, Christian, Lynn and I were talking about, we're thinking we just throw a little blurb into the README that basically says, hey, there's a known issue where the laser cat might turn on you and kill you.
Yeah, and besides, no one really reads the README file anyway.
So what do you guys think? Should we ship it?
Ship it!
Yeah. Pick me up from the pound. Ask me for free software. I'll fry you with my laser beam, mother.
The city keeps on going on. Go down the river with Matty and DJ. Get off a boat and board a plane to JFK and I slept in a week. But it don't seem to matter to the subway.